it is every time. It depends on me, but some places they want to put the pressure on the players, like to play something or not to play something. And of course, the major issue is with the modern pieces. And you know, I feel this several times. Like the presenter is telling me that my audience doesn't like modern. Modern music, and of course this makes me really angry, because like, how can you say about this few hundred people, my audience, like, did he examine the taste of all of them? Of course not. So basically he doesn't like the modern music, and then, you know, he try to find excuses and says that the whole audience doesn't like this music. I mean, the most extreme thing happened to me in Moscow when I wanted to play Mano a Mano by Magnus Lindberg, and the presenter, a lady, she said, you are not allowed to do this. But at the end, anyway, I did it on the stage, announcing the piece on the stage, and literally I hear the movement behind the curtain, right? Behind, I could hear while playing that someone is screaming there, someone is moving there, and it was a little conflict after that. But you know, at the end, like, if someone doesn't allow the artist to express himself, I mean, why should you care about feelings of such a person, right? So. Colleagues, guitarists, they complain that we are somehow not present enough in a big concert halls. We don't play enough with orchestras, and yeah, maybe it's true, right? But also, well, the piano. Piano is everywhere. Piano, piano recitals are in a big concert halls. Piano is playing all the time with orchestra, but. And violin, cello, maybe, right? And the other instruments are also not so well presented as a solo instrument, let's say. And the reason is, I think, that just basically that the guitar is such a intimate instrument, really a chamber instrument. So so to discover the beauty of our instrument, you need a small concert hall, and this gives a feeling of being a little bit out of the mainstream. But so when we think about the poetry, for example, this is the same kind of event, right? The evening of a poem, meeting with a poet. Usually you don't do this in a big concert halls. It's just much more intimate, and that's it. But I have to say that nowadays there are so many fantastic guitar players, really, that I enjoy to listen to them as much as, or even more sometimes, than well-known pianists, violinists, or string quartets, whatever. The art, the intensity and excitement of the music is just as big, or sometimes even bigger.
So, Five Preludes by Lobos. This is a piece that is well known to every guitar player and guitar lover, and we can hear one of two preludes in every competition or exam. To be honest, I never played those preludes when I was a student or younger. This idea came to me because I really I did fall in love with the idea of playing all five preludes as a set, because somehow I feel like those five pieces, they work much better and at least differently than when they are played together rather than separately. So I hope you can also discover some new values in those preludes by listening as one set.
Just the event as a concert, especially with the instrument as fragile as the guitar. It is so quiet, so delicate. You know, very often just a few idiots in a concert hall destroy completely the show, right? For me and for the other players. You know, someone who is coughing, someone who is moving. And actually I discovered this in Japan a few years ago. I went there for the first time in my life. And I play absolutely the best concerts in my life. And then I ask myself, what, why? You know, maybe it's this Japanese food, the sushi, maybe the climate, I know. But then I realized that actually the way they put the concerts together, like how they treat me, how the audience behave. You know, you have a beautiful concert hall, perfect for the guitar, full and full of listeners, and still there is this silence that increase the power of music. It's beautiful, right? If you compare it with some other countries where, you know, the noise, taking pictures during the concerts, recordings with iPhones, going in and out is something normal. Then you ask yourself, okay, so why did I practice so much and why did I travel for 12 hours if like 90% of the beauty that I try to create with my instrument is gone because of this unexpected behavior, right? So of course this is the problem, and very often I'm disappointed. I always try to imagine that actually even if the few people are making a noise or they distract everything, still people can enjoy and listen to it. Thank you.
Hindus metronome.
Okay.
I don't know, surprised with what I'm saying, but you know, I teach very often, and nowadays it looks like everywhere metronome is the god of practicing. Everyone is using the metronome without even knowing and understanding what's the reason of this. And immediately I recognize the students, they practice too much of the metronome. They just, you know, they always follow the downbeat, there are those regular accents, and I have a feeling that metronome sometimes is just killing musicality. It's absolutely killing musicality. So if you are looking for a groove, for a beat, it's much better just to count, to conduct, to dance. Then you understand it much better than by turning on the metronome, which is not rhythmical at the end. Because if you'd like to play something in a rhythmical way, you must give the meaning to the rhythm, or is a sentimental rhythm, or is a powerful rhythm, but both of those extremes, they never fit the metronome beat. So I have to probably write some articles about how terrible it is to use a metronome.